Hey guys, Leviathan here. So I had an interesting weekend that I want to talk to you guys about. No, it has nothing to do with cars, but super bikes. So I don't know how many of my earlier videos you've watched, but I've talked about how I started riding before I actually got into cars. So 5 years ago, I got my first bike, a 250 Kawasaki Ninja. A month after that, I crashed it. A week after that, I got another Kawasaki Ninja. And then after that, I had a Yamaha R6, which was stolen from my building. And then I finally ended up with a Ducati 848 Evo, which I sold along with my Aston before getting the Ferrari F430. And the reason I bring it up is because this weekend I had to take my M test. The way the licensing system works in Canada is a graduated program. So first you start off with your M1 license, which is just a theory test that you take, and you can legally ride with some restrictions. For example, you're not allowed to go on the highways, you're not allowed to take a passenger, and you have to ride between sunrise and sunset. And you're obviously not allowed to have any alcohol in your system. After a certain period, you can qualify to take your M1 exit to get your M2 license. The M2 license is essentially non-restricted, with the exception that you can't have any alcohol in your system and it expires after 5 years. I was actually approaching that 5-year mark and I did not want my license to expire. Otherwise, I'd have to go through that entire graduation system again. The issue is, I have no bike. So I was able to find one location, GTA Exotics, that allowed me to rent out a Kawasaki 650 Ninja. Now that I have the motorbike, I had to worry about the licensing portion. So, given it's been a couple years since I've been riding, I thought it would be best to take a course. So the way the course works is it's an evening session, with the next day being a full practical course, followed by the test immediately after. So I decided to go with Riders Training Institute, which I have to say was a fantastic course, very well organized, and essentially the course is really designed to make you a safer rider. They don't teach you any of the operational skill, but they just teach you how to be a safer rider. So things like checking your blind spot, your mirrors, and how to ride defensively, and that's 99% of the course and the test. So it was about 7 hours worth of riding, followed by a 30-minute test where they trail you in a car and give you instructions. And I passed. I'm actually really grateful because everything worked out perfectly. And there's so many things that could have gone wrong. For example, first I had to rely on the people from the rental place meeting me at 7 a.m. On a Saturday, that's a big risk. Next, I had to make sure that the bike had the insurance as well as proof of ownership, which I could not find. But luckily, it was hidden away in the passenger seat. Next was the test itself, which I had to pass. Otherwise, if I had to go through the booking process again and retake the test, my license would have expired. So I'm actually really grateful and really relieved that everything worked out in the end. So now that I have my M license, the question is, do I plan to get into bikes? That's a great question, but the issue I have with bikes now is while I had an incredible experience riding for about 2-3 years, when you're living in the city where I am at, it's not really an experience or something that you enjoy. After a while, it just becomes a survival game, and that's a game that is just never fun to play. So yes, a part of me really miss riding motorbikes, but given the risks and the limited time you actually have to ride, I didn't feel like it was worth it. Maybe a few years from now, when I move out of the city or potentially a different country where there's more enjoyable roads, I'll reconsider having a bike. But for now, I'm just sticking to cars. Wanted to share a slightly different perspective with you guys to give you a bit more insight about my hobbies and my passion and about me as well. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. So until next time, take care.